Hey Tony, my name is Erin, and as promised, I have a short video for you just showing a few tips on how to help grow your business online. So without further ado, we will go ahead and get started. The three things that I'll cover in the video are going to be content, citations, and backlinks. So we'll go ahead and we'll start with content. So content is going to be anything that you can see on your website here. That does also include the pictures, what they're saved as, and what's behind the pictures. That can be considered content as well. So these are things that the search engine can read and kind of get an idea of what services that you're offering and the location that you're trying to target as well. So having unique, authoritative content and enough of it so you can add in those keywords and key phrases is super important. That way you can be found for the services that you are targeting. So I would certainly suggest adding some more content to your website. I can't see what your pictures are saved as or what's behind them, so I'm not sure if Google is counting any of that as content for you. I do see that you have some sub pages here, and I did see that you have a blog as well, which is great because that is certainly another way that you can add content. But to Google, content is king, so the more the better. And again, it just really gives you an opportunity to add in more keywords and key phrases that people are going to be searching for. So that's really the only tip that I have for you as far as that goes. So we'll go ahead and we'll move on. The second tip that I have for you is going to be citations. And I did pull up a Google search here of photographers in North Carolina. So the first thing you'll see here is going to be called the map pack. And citations have a lot to do with the map pack. So what a citation is essentially is anywhere that you can add your business name, your business phone number, your business address, in directories all throughout the web. So you may be asking yourself, what is a directory and how the heck do I get myself listed in one of those? So a directory would be things like Facebook, which I know that you do have, which is great. LinkedIn, Yellow Pages, Yelp, and anywhere else online that allows you to enter your business details and services. So in order to rank high on the maps here, you would want to take a look at what your competition has as far as where they're being listed in directories, and you would want to go out and get yourself listed there as well. But you would not just want to stop there either. You would want to take whatever your competition has, get that, and then some. So anything your competition is doing really, you want to double, triple that. So that will help you to rank high in the search here as well. So now that we have covered the content and the citations, we will move on to the last thing, which is going to be backlinks. And backlinks has a lot to do with this section underneath the map pack, which is called the organic section here. And the way that backlinks work is basically there's a website out there that is taking a link from their site and pushing it to your site, which is pushing power to your website as well, and of course potentially bringing traffic to you. But not all backlinks are created equal. So say for example that you did some pictures for somebody who owns an ice cream shop, and they've decided that they're going to take a link from their website and send one to your website. But that link, of course, is going to be all about ice cream. So it's really not going to be very helpful for you. You would want to get links from other photographers, other photography companies, sending a link back to your site saying, yes, she is a photographer, she's a photographer company. That's going to be a lot more powerful because it's unique, but it's also relevant to your industry. So looking at one of the tools that I have here, this is called Arifs. It didn't pull up any of the information for you. It doesn't look like it's registering any referring domains or backlinks or keywords for you. But I did just want to show you. I did pull up one of your competitors on Google. It looks like this is called Fearless Photographers. They have over 3,000 referring domains, giving them 243,000 backlinks, which is getting them found for over 19,000 keywords and pushing about 14,000 people to their website monthly. So let's take a look and we'll see what keywords they're using here. So this section here, the volume is showing you about how many searches per month that this particular keyword or key phrase is being searched for. So like they have North Carolina wedding photographers, which has a high volume, and that would be what we would call a buyer intent keyword. So when someone says, you know what, I think I'd really like to get some pictures taken, these are the kind of things that they're going to be searching for when they're looking for photographers or looking for your services. It looks like this photography company also has a lot of different locations listed, like Colorado, Australia, Florida, wedding photographer, South Carolina. So they're being found for all of these things. So essentially, like I said before, in order to beat out your competition, you just want to make sure that you're being found in a lot of the same places that they're being found. And just like the citations, you don't want to just stop there. You want to go get whatever they have and then add more to that. So that's really pretty much it. I do hope that this video has been educational for you and helpful. If I can answer any other questions, or if you would like to know more about what I do and how I can kind of help grow your business online, please reach out to me and we can chat. And if not, no worries at all. I hope that you're able to take these tips and put them into action, and that everything was helpful for you. Thank you for taking the time to watch this, and you have a great rest of your night, Toni.